light, 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 kicking off the 2-year light expansion. Light, 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 light. Let there be light. Let there be light. Let us evaporate our fear of the one light. There's only one light. There's only one light. Not many, just one light. Even this electromagnetic spectrum energy, even that is light. Believe it or not, even form is light. There's only one light reflecting the desire for experience for all. Just one light. It's only one light. So we say light, 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 light. No mistakes in the light. There are no mistakes. There's nothing to be corrected. There's nothing to be fixed. There's nothing to be healed. Simply choose again. Choose once again. Instead of trying to do what we have done, which is try and change the light. So we say that it's no longer responsive. We've tried to condense the light, condense, dense, shrink, shrink, condense, dense, dense, freeze, 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 concretize, 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 down to the point where we can say, oh, the light no longer is responsive to our desires. Therefore, the will of God has been defeated, you see. We're not free. In other words, we're not free. One moment. Ah, light, 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 light. We're not free. We think, oh, we're not free. You see, the light no longer is responsive. Not true. It is not true. So light, 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 light is, it is the same light as it's always been. It's always the same light. It's always responsive. We must drop the notion that somehow it is non-functional. It's not functioning properly. This is the great delusion. This is the great lie. And there's a ton of work on that angle that says we're healed to, here to heal the light. We're here to, it goes on and on and on and on and on. This is the self-deception that we've been working on. And that may seem full of light and all this stuff, but that is not the way. That is not the way. There is no sin. There's no sin against God. There's no sin against anything. Everything is perfectly functional. Reality is totally functional. This is reality. Even this attempt to undo reality is reality. The light is totally responsive. And it's all great. It's all great. There is no problem whatsoever except the continuity problem. I searched on YouTube for something to add production value. I cannot find anything. It is the most pathetic situation I've ever seen. I look for Creative Commons, anything to use, nothing, nothing, nothing. What is wrong with this world? Wow. I said, I'll have to do it, you know, tape it myself. I don't have the time. So I just swiveled the camera here. To give, you know, something beautiful to you, something uplifting to you. But my gosh, what a desert YouTube is. What a desert, unfortunately. I spend huge chunks of time searching through thousands and thousands and thousands of videos. Is there anything that has the light in it, you know, that really has the light? No, I can't find it. Oh well, oh well. This isn't bad, is it? This isn't bad. The light says, look, don't worry, I'll provide something for you. So, instead of thinking about the problems of the world, say light inwardly, light. We're talking to the source of all life, of all that is, the pure, clear light. That is all light. That is all life. That is everything. And we are saying, yes, yes, there's nothing wrong. We're saying, yes, there's nothing wrong with the light. There's nothing wrong with us. There's nothing wrong with the light. There's nothing wrong whatsoever. There are no problems. Everything is a perfect expression of the one. Right now, everything is a perfect expression of the one. Nothing has to be changed. Nothing has to be fixed. What we do have a continuity problem, in that we've been trying to make the light non-functional. And so we have all this evidence we can point to and say, hey, that doesn't look like functional. I didn't ask for that to happen. Yes, we did. Yes, we did. Yes, we did. We asked for everything to appear so that it seemed as though the light is non-functional. So we could claim, we've been able to separate from God. Our will is greater than God. We have some will able to separate from the oneness. So we've been trying to manufacture all this appearances that we can claim, wait a minute, the light can't possibly be functional. No, but it is functional. It is functional. It's never lost its functionality at all. It never will. So we can give up this ridiculous attempt to manufacture all this, you know, bizarre stuff, death, sickness, form, decrepancy, decay. We don't have to keep on saying, hey, light, I want to see death, you know, because then I can point to death and say, hey, light, you're obviously non-functional, see, because I didn't ask for that. That is not true. So we're lying, basically. Self-deception. And of course, light, we ask light, hey, light, should it show us death? And of course, light does that. It's totally obedient to what we, our desire, what we want to experience. And then we also claim, hey, light, if you were functional, you wouldn't be showing us death. Yes, it would. It would show us whatever we want, wherever we choose to see. So it is totally functional. Light is totally functional. Now, where is this message? I want to hear more of this, you know. I want to hear more. There should be millions of people on the planet tuned in, you know, to say, yeah, this message, amplifying truth, the message of truth here. Instead, it's all, you know, circuitous. It's hedging, everyone's hedging their bets. It's not time to hedge your bets anymore. Decide, you know, hey, truth is true. Nothing else is true. There is no non-functionality. In spite of all the appearances, we ask for all those appearances that give us the illusion of non-functionality, a mirage of non-functionality. But everything is totally functional, perfectly functional. Don't hedge your bets. Say, yeah. Say, this is true. This is true. Taken a lifetime of effort to get to this point where we say, no, don't hedge our bets, and say it publicly, say it to the world, say, you know, this, shout it from the rooftops, don't hide your light under a bushel, you know. So, a lifetime of effort just to cast off this unbelievable hedging of betsism that is this world and maybe many other dimensions, many other worlds, etc. Everyone's saying, well, I want it to seem like that I'm, you know, helping the light help you. I'm helping the light help you. Light doesn't need any help. It's perfect. It's perfect. It's perfect. We just need to choose a new idea. Say, hey, Let's hallucinate space instead of form space. See, form space seems to be heavy evidence that the light is no longer the light, and that its functionality is crumbling. It's crumbling. But when we see form as simply space, which is what it is fundamentally, there's no crumbling of space, is there? Is spaciousness, total seamless spaciousness, is that crumbling? Is there anything there to crumble? Is there anything there to decay? Is there anything there to get sick? Is there anything there to die? No. No. I never know what I'm going to do next. So I can't promise I'm going to have all sorts of great light shows or something, you know, just to like give you a feeling, because I don't know if it gives you any feeling at all, really, here in this world. But the words are important, for sure, pointing us to the truth. I mean, we can get an upliftment, a total upliftment. I don't know, maybe, possible. If some watch, I know there's some that are watching. And maybe something is percolating. I know it's not easy. I spent a whole lifetime at it, so I know it's not easy. But I know that stick-to-itiveness works. And I know that deadlines work. We have a deadline. We have a 2-year deadline now. Okay. So, having a deadline and say, I'm just going to go for broke. I'm going to go for it. I'm not going to hedge my bets anymore. I'm saying, light, you are perfect. Everything is perfect. I rest in your perfection. I rest in your perfection. I don't need to fix you. I don't need to point out, hey, light, you're doing something not right here. I need to help you out because this is not quite right. No, 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 no. The way to help out is to assert to the presence of it. Everything's perfect. Everything is perfect right now. And always has been perfect right now. There's nothing stuck in time. If everything's perfect expression of the light, does the light need some time in order to express itself perfectly? No, it does not. The light doesn't need any, even an instant. Does the light thinking say, I don't know, am I gonna do this one? Oh, okay, I guess I will. The light doesn't think like that. It's instantaneous. Creation is instantaneous. The light is instantaneous. Longchenpa calls it spontaneity, self-sprung spontaneity. In other words, instantaneous. Instantaneous. That was a word of Keith Dowman using the word of spontaneity. I would say I'm going to use the word instantaneous. Instantaneous. There's no time. There is no gap. There's no gap of saying, well, I gotta wait for something else to complete before I express what you're asking me to express. Imagine if we express like, oh, I want to not be sick. Does light say, I need to wait until the sickness gets better before I manifest non-sickness? No, 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 no. If whatever we desire instantaneously, that is what is present. We are simply asking sequential things that appear similar to the previous to claim like, oh, you see, there is process, there is time, then to say the light's non-functional. We have to wait. So, well, it does not responding. There's a response gap or something. There's no response gap. There is no response gap. There is no gap. There is no gap. But we've done an ingenious job of making it seem like there's such a thing as time, time-space, distance, time-space, form, all this like, oh, the bottle has to be a bottle the next moment, and maybe light can gradually transform it or something. That is not true. We are simply asking form to continue to keep its appearances and then gradually change, etc. So light is presenting that to us. But if we asked a bottle, you know, this plant, this leaf, whatever, if we said, I want it to be, you know, a different color or something, and that in unequivocally we said, yes, this right now, instantaneous, So obviously there's a continuity gap between time, the belief in time and process, and instantaneousness. There's always been instantaneous. There's only been instantaneousness. But we have sequenced it to give the mirage, the false appearance of time. It's very ingenious, very creative, right? But it's creativity being used to deceive ourselves. So it puts us in this black hole of thinking that, you know, oh, light isn't functional. We have to somehow, with our thinking and our thoughts and what we do, you know, change stuff, you know, use materiality and energy and all this stuff. Not true. None of that is true. None of it is true. Light. The light is perfect. The light is flawless. The light is totally functional. The light is instantaneous. Reality is exactly the same as it's always been. Nothing is amiss. Everything is functioning perfectly. No hedging bets anymore. No bet hedging anymore. Now, we're afraid, like, hey, if we say this, there's going to be instantaneous change. Not so, because of the continuity fear that we have. Theoretically, they're good, but the continuity fear that we have, we say, hey, light, could you change things, you know? I want things to change gradually. Light says, sure, no problem. But don't draw the inference from that the light is somehow non-functional, or it's slow, or something. Not true, not true. If we wanted to change things quickly, light would help however quickly we want it. With whatever appearance we want. We want appearance of rapid rapidity, it's there. Appearance of gradualness, it's there. If we want instantaneous, appearance of instantaneous, it's there. But the appearance of gradualness is instantaneous, the appearance of rapidity is instantaneous, and the appearance of instantaneousness is instantaneous. It's all instantaneous. No time involved whatsoever. No time involved whatsoever. And my foot is going to sleep. Okay. So, no more hedging our bets, folks. No more hedging our bets. This stuff is not scary. I'm not scared in the least bit saying this. Is everything going to become instantaneous? No, because I have a continuity fear like everybody does. Like everyone does. Except the no-doubters, as I call them, the no-doubters. The no-doubters don't have any continuity fear. So, there are instances when they speed things up, if that's what we desire. If we truly desire that, they can seem to be there and hold our hand, as it were, as we speed things up. Say we want something, and it, you know, things can happen really fast if that's what we choose. And the no-doubters can reassure us, say, sure, if you want that, that's great, no problem. It's also great if you want a gradual, an appearance of graduality, whatever, appearance of rapidity, whatever you want, it's all fine. Don't worry, everything is functional. Everything is perfect. Nothing's out of place. There's nothing happening that is amiss. Nothing happening. There never will be anything happening that's amiss. Bring this to an end before my leg goes entirely asleep. Be like that crane, you know, it's just gliding in the through beautiful vegetation, just lush, fresh, immaculate vegetation, and you're just gliding through this massive, lush forest. How about that for a nice experience? No worry of harm or anything. I mean, being a bird is not such a bad gig, in some ways, right? We think we got a great, but birds, you know, just very nice experience. Just floating through this unbelievably beautiful, fragrant, fresh, radiant, vibrant, calm, peaceful forest canopy, semi-tropical canopy of beautiful sounds everywhere, colors and flowers, and just floating through that, just floating through it, That's all. Nowhere to go. Nothing to do. Nothing to accomplish. Nothing to fix. Nothing to heal. Nothing to change. Just enjoying the experience. I don't know why. I don't know why any of this is particularly difficult, actually. It's a question of familiarity, actually. Once you get familiar with it, you just say, yeah, what's the big deal? Of course, not a problem. So we can all get to that, for sure. Just stick to it, stick to it, stick to it, stick to it, stick to it. All right, very great. That's it for this video. Just imagine it's floating through the wonderful foliage. That's it.